His love is wonderful. Praise the Lord for His goodness to us and His great love wherewith He loved us and the joy we have, joy to the world. You know, I see that over and over and over. You know, even yesterday, you know, we talked about Mary and Joseph Monday and Old Testament Prophecy Tuesday and No Room in the Inn on Wednesday. And then yesterday we talked about the shepherds and how they were sore afraid. And the angels appeared to them and the angels said, fear not, you don't have to be afraid. Good tidings, great joy, and which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And we're going to pick it up right there and move on forward. The Bible says, this shall be a sign unto you. Ye shall find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host praising God. By the way, we ought to spend a little bit more time praising God, don't you think? I don't think we praise God enough. I think we're always looking to see how much praise we can get. And instead of saying, God, to you be the glory and to you be the praise, and you've given us joy and you've supplied every need. Well, moving on here, he says they were praising, the heavenly hosts were praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace, goodwill toward men. Now, we're still praying for that peace. We're living in a world of turmoil. We certainly need that God of peace. We certainly need that Savior who will give us the Prince of Peace. That's who Jesus is. And he says, on earth, peace, and then this, goodwill toward men. You know, all that God did in sending his Son, all that Christ did in the sacrifice that he made, all that the Holy Spirit is doing in indwelling the believers and trying to guide them and help them, all of that was for man's sake, for mankind. God so loved the world. That is amazing. The Bible goes on to say, and it came to pass as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, let us now go even unto Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. By the way, they didn't say, I wonder if it really happened. They said, it's come to pass. They were instantly believers. They took God at his word. They took those angelic messengers at their word. They just believed God. They believed that God had sent them, and they went to see. They wanted to see it firsthand. They were excited about it. You know, it's an amazing thing to me. People that call themselves Christians, I mean many of the people that call themselves Christians, you almost have to drag them to church to come and hear the praises of God sang, to hear the word of God preached, to have fellowship with other Christians, to be in the presence of the Lord through prayer as a local body of believers. And all those things, there's so many good things that we have, and you have to beg, borrow, steal to get them there. It's just amazing. And they said, we want to go. We want to see it. And that's what they did. And I pray that God will give you and me that kind of spirit all of our days. I pray that till the day I go to heaven, I'll be anxious to want to be in church. You know, our family's been exposed to COVID, and we haven't been to church for a couple of services now. And we're going on through this thing, got one more week, and then our 14 days of being, what it was called, quarantined. Our 14 days of quarantine will be over. And we'll be back in church, and I praise the Lord for that. And we're just excited about it. This will be our last Sunday to have to miss. And I'm excited about being in church on Sunday and Sunday morning, and then beginning in January, even Sunday night and Wednesday night, and for Bible study, for the Sunday school hour. And let us even go into Bethlehem. Let us go see this thing. Let us go be where the action is. Let's go take part and be there. And the Bible says they came with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the babe lying in a manger. And when they had seen it, now look at this. I want you to get the shepherd's response. We'll be done with this week's series on Christmas. Maybe we'll have another week next week to do the same thing. But the Bible says, and when they had seen it, that they being the shepherds, when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child. When they saw it, they did exactly what they knew they had to do. They went everywhere, told everybody. Everybody they came in contact with, they were anxious. They, in our day, I guess they would have had their pockets stuffed full of tracts so they could give one to everybody they came in contact with. They would be rehearsing in their mind how they were going to tell the next person they saw. Or, man, I said that backwards that time. Let me get that straight. I want to say it right the next time. And they would have been working on that thing. They were so excited. I'm sure they got tongue-tied about it some along the way in their excitement and their joy and their thrill and wanting to tell everybody. The Bible says they made known abroad the saying, this in verse 17, which was told them concerning the child, and all they that heard it wondered at these things, at those things which were told them by the shepherd. But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them, glorifying and praising God. Whoa, that's another goal for our life, isn't it? Wouldn't it be good if every day we'd start the day simply saying, God, help me to glorify you today, and I want to give you the praise and the thanksgiving for all the blessings you've given us. Boy, wouldn't that be a wonderful way to do it? And just get that day started right and live that day for Christ and looking for the blessings and the reasons to rejoice instead of the reasons to complain and getting the fear out of our life. Fear not, they said. We've got glad tidings of great joy. And that's what God wants us to enjoy. Let's pray together. We'll go off with a song. Heavenly Father, thank you for the Word of God. Thank you that it is quick and powerful and sharp. Lord, I pray each of us, what we hear when we read the Bible, when we hear someone preaching or teaching it, when we study it, Lord, may it have an impact on our lives. Lord, we know it's a life-changing book if we'll allow it to be. And we give you the praise for it. And we thank you for loving us. Thank you for our church. Thank you for our people. And I pray you'll bless us for Jesus' sake. Amen.